Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Bhagna Chigrupati Nara, a consultant breast surgeon currently working in Hyderabad. Today's subject is on duct ectasia. It's more of a medical subject, so I'm going to keep it short. To give you a brief on the anatomy of the breast is made out of milk-producing glands, which are known as lobules, and ducts, which carry the milk to the nipple and the surrounding supportive system. When these ducts become widened or shorter, it's called duct ectasia. And it generally occurs in women about the age of 45. This could be a normal age-related process, or it could be because of any underlying condition. When these ducts become infected or inflamed, the condition is known as periductal mastitis, and it's generally seen in smokers. So what are the symptoms of these conditions? Duct ectasia generally presents with greenish-colored discharge. If it's foul-smelling, it could be infected. Periductal mastitis can often present with redness of the breast, a lump, generalized tiredness, lethargy, fever, and again, nipple discharge. So how do you diagnose this condition? When a patient presents to you with such symptoms to the clinic, physical examination is the first step. Imaging with either a mammogram or an ultrasound, and in very rare cases, you might require an MRI. If there is an active nipple discharge, and if it's foul-smelling, yellowish, or it looks infected, a pus culture sensitivity, a swab, might be sent. So how do you treat this condition? Duct ectasia is generally a normal physiological process that might occur in any woman. It tends to resolve on its own. However, if it does not resolve and you continue to have symptoms, you might be advised removal of a single duct, which is called a microductectomy, or all the ducts below the nipple, which is known as Hadfield surgery. Periductal mastitis is generally treated symptomatically, and that might be just with antibiotics or an aspiration of the pus. You might be advised removal of the ducts, the entire system of ducts below the nipple, based on the complexity of the condition. Remember that duct ectasia or periductal mastitis are not associated with any risk of cancer. I hope this answers all your questions regarding duct ectasia. If you have any queries, please feel free to reach out to us on the numbers given below. Thank you.